Husky.
Yeah, man.
Blue Magic.
Yeah, man.
Prosek.
Yeah, man.
Charlie, yesterday I saw something online which made me happy.
Tell me about it,
the
boy.
The Prosek e-learning platform.
Okay. For the students,
for the Prosek school,
the e-learning platform. How was that?
Well, somebody shared the link and then I went there. So if you're a student of Prosek, you go to the platform, you enter your name and your class, and then they'll give you login details,
and then you can work
and continue your academics
whilst you are home.
It was fantastic. I know the government of Ghana is doing something like this, but for individual schools to also show innovation like this,
wow!
It tells us that in adversity, We bring out our best.
Yes,
and if we
indeed
continue to do this, we can wean ourselves off the dependence on others. And maybe Ghana will truly be beyond aid and beyond
this
help.
This one, is it Nana Wan Wam? Is that what they say? How do they say it? Wan Wam. What is it, Wan Wam or Wan Wam?
We'll take it.
Yeah. Yeah.
We'll take the Wam like that.
Therefore. Anyway, let's go to the headline.
Front page of the Daily Graphic comes with a nice photo of Mr. Ken Ofori-Atta, usually in white, smiling.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you why. Mm-hmm. $1 billion drops Friday, says the IMF. COVID-19 won't stall cocoa syndication loan, says the Cocoa Board. Zoomline rolls out school disinfection program. 465 citizens arrested. COVID-19 not a death sentence. Stop the stigmatization, health service boss advises.
Now, the publisher, fear grips ministers as Ghana Link Unipass fails again in Takrade. There's a picture of Mr. Yawasafu Mafo, Mr. Kweku Kwating, and Nick Danso on the front page. 406 arrested over lockdown rules. This is according to the police. There's ACP Lydia Donkor's picture on the front page. Kill me if I can't cure COVID-19. Herbalist Des Ghana Health Service. We should not entertain such stories. Tor MD hot over MP's bribery scandal. And God not responsible for COVID-19, Palmer Buckle. That's from Bernard's interview.
Front page of the BNFT paper, oil contribution to GDP to drop by $2.5 billion. 2020 cocoa syndication loan will come off despite COVID-19 disruptions. That story is also here. Africa risk losing $500 billion in tax revenue, according to the AU.
Now, if you check citynewsroom.com, we have a lot more stories. That's voter registration exercise in places not under lockdown. This is Sam Okujeto to EC.
Yeah.
TUC cancels 2020 May Day celebration over COVID-19 outbreak.
Okay.
Nigerians who tested positive for COVID-19 refused treatment at Ga East Hospital.
Are they serious?
NPP suspends parliamentary primaries indefinitely amidst COVID-19 scare. And COVID-19, be diligent in spending IMF's $1 billion loan, Mahama advises government. There's also an update. Cases are now, we have an update of the cases. 636 confirmed cases.
Yes.
8 people have died. 17 have officially recovered after the 2 tests. And we
66
have,
are waiting for their second
test. Yes, and we have 611 active cases. Now, if you go to citybusinessnews.com, it will cost us dearly if we misuse $1 billion IMF loan.
Okay.
Edusa Akodie urges efficiency.
Is that a loan or special drawing? Anyway, let's continue.
First National Bank cuts interest rate by 2% to alleviate impact of COVID-19.
Okay.
Guta leadership demands to play a role in disbursement of $600 million to SMEs. And COVID-19, government gives MTN, Vodafone free spectrum for 3 months to meet data needs. KPMG is also speaking. Ghana can take advantage of COVID-19 to boost local production.
Let me take you to Major Online. How Tor MD allegedly facilitated bribe payments to government officials, MPs in 2015-2016. Also, Asante Beko rejects bribery allegations by US SEC. Meanwhile, new budget statement needed to reflect COVID-19 impact on Ghana's economy, according to KPMG, as you read. And Ghanaian experts' best popular myths about coronavirus. Other stories. Another significant increase sends Ghana's COVID cases to 635. And then 7 nurses, 3 doctors who came into contact with Obor's late father test negative for coronavirus.
Okay, so I'll take you to some
FM news before COVID-19. Cut down your ministers to save money, Mahama to Akufo-Addo. Also, Mahama distributes food items to 20,000 households.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, take food distribution at home. Take food distribution to homes Hajji Ali Mahama directs NADBO. This is the statement you read yesterday on television. COVID-19, take food distribution to homes. Minister for Local Government directs NADBO. And then, as we all know, the case is now 636. Meanwhile, How Telecoms Chamber is helping to fight COVID-19. They have a very interesting platform. Meanwhile, Bainé Champion says, giving is humanity, in his donation to seven constituencies
yesterday,
of items worth over 800,000 CDs.
Now, the Ghana News Agency, 17 persons clinically recover from COVID-19. This is according to the Ghana Health Service. National Ambulance Service appeals for PPE. Vodafone Call Center provides guidance on COVID-19. Now, if you check other stories, we compete with animals for water.
Damwantian woman, I hope I have the name.
So it's a town, and they say they compete with animals for water. Ghanaians advised to observe social distancing against COVID-19 spread. If you go to the Daily Guide Network,
DGN, okay,
website.
What are they talking about?
They also have some stories. NPP suspends parliamentary primaries. Scrap dealer spray substance into the eyes of the police. All illegal immigrants arrested. 41 illegal immigrants arrested at Babili. Upper West records 7 COVID-19 cases. And Okoboy vetting fast-tracked. Now, the Ghanaian Times, finally for you, Bernard. They also have some interesting stories. Scores besiege Kwame Nkrumah Circle for food.
Charlie.
There's a picture of a lot of people at the Kwame Nkrumah Circle trying to get food. Stop hyping players we want to buy. Hart CEO tells supporters. there are more stories. COVID-19 has not affected cargo vessel traffic into Ghana, says Maritime Authority.
Okay.
And the IMF stories here.
This
IMF
is still on GNA.
Yes. This is Ghanaian Times.
Ghanaian Times. Yes. Okay. So IMF, you've done Daily Guide, you've done Ghanaian Times, you've done GNA, you've done Joy City, Star Business. City. All right, Goffert, take us international. But before you do that, I want to read something. Please. Just to remind people of where we are.
All right.
Bernard, it seems people are really not taking this stay-home campaign seriously. Take my neighborhood, for instance. Educated men who are supposed to know better meet every morning and evening to play football, tennis, and even sit around and drink without regard for social distancing. Some of them even go for jogging in groups every day. Yes, in this era. Meanwhile, these are the very people who turn around and complain about what government is not doing. I'm worried about this indifferent posture. We are the front line to end this. It really starts with us being responsible and staying at home to flatten the curve. A very angry listener sending this message to me from Pram Pram. So please, I will read it later again, just for people who are doing jogging and things and not obeying the lockdown rules.
All right, Bernard, I'll take you around the world. I'll start from the continent, though. I'll start from the East African. Okay. Kenya's coronavirus cases rise to 216. Five of the new patients are Kenyans and three are foreign nationals. Museveni extends Uganda lockdown to May 5. Yes, Museveni is just extending that thing, Charlie. And then there's also a feature on nightmare of Kenya's quarantine centers. There's been a lot of things written about that. Now, if you go to the Mail and Guardian in South Africa, there's a huge kerfuffle about the ban on alcohol. So why total ban on selling alcohol is irrational? Is the lead.
Why does alcohol cure corona?
Well, people are complaining about that. There's even a court case around this, and also the COVID-19 burial problem for South Africa. Also, sad story. Police officers, prison officials, and inmates in isolation as COVID-19 hits correctional services. Now, if you go to the Daily Nation, which is the
big
Kenya, the biggest outlet there, they are saying that you'll be arrested over face mask. Now, if you do not wear your face mask in public, you'll be fined the equivalent of 20,000 shillings.
Wow.
Yes, and mass testing to be conducted at KPA, that is the Kenya Port Authorities. They're going to do mass testing. I will take you now to Japan and the Japan Times. Very, 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 very sad stories coming from Japan regarding the corona. If you go to Japan Times, Japan coronavirus-related deaths hit single-day record. As total infections top 8,000. Now, also another headline there, untraceable cases in Japan raise fear, outbreak spiraling out of control.
Japan,
yes, this is Japan. Then I would take you to China and the South China Morning Post, your favorite South China Morning Post. China's initial coronavirus outbreak in Wuhan spread twice as fast as we thought, new study suggests. And according to the new study, each carrier was infecting 5.7 people on average.
No longer three.
No longer three.
5.7 people on average.
On average, yes. Now, if you also stay on the South China Morning Post, does aircon help spread coronavirus? Chinese study of three families in a restaurant suggests so.
Aircon.
Yeah, that is also... Let me give you other
headlines. And you know, because headlines. China got their cases earlier, a lot of the studies coming in from there could help us. Although we are not happy with the fact that they want to censor
the information that is coming out.
So we need to read that with a pinch of salt.
Yes. Now, Malawi, Bernard, have declared a 21-day virus lockdown.
Okay.
That is according to the BBC. Nigeria reports biggest one-day rise in cases.
Hey.
30 new cases confirmed yesterday with 11 deaths. So I will give you
a Nigeria's bit. Case count is still below ours.
It's 373 now.
But they have 11 deaths.
Yes, with
we
11
have
deaths.
Six,
yes.
100 and something with eight deaths.
Yeah.
All right. Still with Nigeria. Yeah,
so that is the Nigeria angle. Then I would take
before
you to CNN.
On, there's a BBC story, two BBC stories. Why lockdowns may not be the answer in Africa. It's an interesting feature.
I've read it. That is Professor Duval.
Yes, you didn't mention it. And then Ajiman Bedu, our footballer, is on the front page of the BBC. COVID, my brush with death and seeking justice for my sister. You know, the Hellas Verona,
Ajiman Bedu. His sister was murdered.
And then, of course,
month.
US to halt funding to WHO over coronavirus.
Yes,
this is the biggest story.
Story. I was getting to that on CNN.
This morning,
since you've touched on that, I will leave it and then talk to you about more than 26,000 coronavirus deaths reported in the US. And yesterday, there were 2,405 new deaths linked to COVID-19 and reported in the US. So globally, this is
all right. So let's start with the stories from our local platforms. Let's do the graphic and then
let's
we'll
start
do
with money.
Some of the websites. Yes, the money story.
Okay, let's start with the money dropping on Friday. Skanabu front page of the Daily Graphic says that the $1 billion interest free loan from the International Monetary Fund will be transferred to Ghana's account on Friday. The fund will be used to mitigate the impact of the raging coronavirus disease pandemic on the lives of the people and the economy. It will be the biggest loan facility received from the IMF in Ghana's 63-year-old history with the Bretton Woods Institution. The resident representative of the IMF in Ghana, Dr. Albert Tunamama, told the Daily Graphic yesterday that the institution will issue a one-off transfer of the funds to the Bank of Ghana on or before Friday. The disbursement is one-off. There is no tranching, the IMF resident representative said in an email response to questions from the Daily Graphic. So we are getting the money, boom, boom, boom. Now on utilization, Dr. Tunamama explained that the IMF expected the loan to address the urgent fiscal and BOP needs that Ghana is facing as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. Quote, this disbursement will also improve confidence and catalyze support from other development partners. He said, unlike previous IMF loan assistance that were under special programs, the $1 billion loan was not under a program, and Ghana does not have conditionality or targets to review at regular intervals.
Now, there's a story by Ernest Ahimful on citynewsroom.com. He's working from home, but he writes, be diligent in spending IMF's $1 billion loan, Mahama advises government.
And the story says, former President John Mahama has advised the Akufo-Addo government to be diligent in applying the $1 billion loan facility the IMF approved for Ghana under the RCF. The executive board of IMF announced the approval of the loan on Monday, April 13, 2020. And the money is to help Ghana address the fiscal imbalance of payments needs. Now, John Mahama, in a Facebook stream to announce his donation of food items to 20,000 households in the country, said the IMF's facility is timely. He, however, urged the government to be prudent in expending the loan.
Now, the other big story this morning is how Tor MD allegedly facilitated bribe payments to government officials, MPs in 2015-2016. The story is on multiple websites. It's on GhanaReport.com. It's on MyJoyOnline. It's on CityNewsroom.com.
If you go to CityBusinessNews.com as well, I never bribed government officials, MPs in power deal.
So let me just give some highlights of the original story and then his reaction. So the managing director of Tamar Refinery, Asante Beko, has been charged by U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission for arranging payments for the Ghana government and some legislators in 2015-2016. Mr. Beko's name was to gain his move was to gain approval for a client's power plant project. Court documents from U.S. prosecutors said the tall boss's role as former executive of a UK-based financial services company, the subsidiary, was to develop investment banking businesses for the subsidiary and the holding company. This, which included identifying and arranging financing, restructuring, or merger transactions for clients and assisting with the work necessary to complete these transactions. Then they reproduce below how he is said to have schemed to facilitate $4.5 million bribe payments to government officials, $66,000 to MPs, and pocketed $2 million in the year 2015-2016. He crafted and developed and carried out the bribery scheme with the knowledge or under the circumstances that made it substantially certain that all or a portion of the money paid to the intermediary company would be paid as bribes to the government officials. This is the allegation on the charge sheet. He's reacted and said that he is what?
Yes, City Business News writes that Mr. Asantebeko has denied arranging at least $2.5 million in bribes meant to be paid to Ghana government officials and members of parliament in a bid to help a Turkish company secure a power purchase agreement in Ghana. Asantebeko, who is currently the managing director of the Temple Oil Refinery, has been charged by the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission for allegedly making payments to gain approval for a client's power plant project from 2015 through at least 2016. And the former banker in a statement clarified that although the US SEC had initiated proceedings against him, allegations that he bribed government officials and MPs are completely false.
Now, the latest on COVID-19, Ghana's case count is how much?
636.
Kojo, do you have the details of that one?
Yes, I'll give you the details of that one.
With 17 new cases confirmed by health officials yesterday.
We have 636 cases in total that is confirmed.
Mm-hmm.
In the routine surveillance, we have 268. Mm-hmm. 17 have recovered.
Mm-hmm.
241 are responding to treatment.
Mm-hmm.
2 are critical or moderately ill, and 8 have died. In the mandatory quarantine, 105 confirmed, 105 responding to treatment.
Mm-hmm.
In the Tamale case, we read a story earlier where some of those arrested in Tamale are being brought to Ghana East and they are refusing treatment.
Mm-hmm.
10 people were confirmed in Tamale, 10 are responding to treatment, we are told.
Mm.
And in the Ghana enhanced contact tracing, 253 people confirmed, 253.
There appears to be treatment. A slight anomaly in the figures for the Ghana surveillance routine, because yesterday the figure there was 292. Today it's come down to 268. Now, usually the confirmed cases for each category does not reduce. We'll try and clarify that later on today. So that's the story. Now, as a consequence of the COVID-19, let me read a few stories around things that are happening. So TUC has cancelled their 2020 May Day celebration.
Mm-hmm.
That's story number one. MPP suspends parliamentary primaries indefinitely amid COVID-19 scare. But there's a story I want you to read. Start voter registration exercise in places not under lockdown. I find that pretty interesting.
Yes, and it's on City Newsroom.
I don't know how that is possible.
Still written by Ernest Ahimfo, working from home.
Yeah, everybody.
And the story says, a senior legal practitioner and former president of the Ghana Bar Association, Samo Kujeto, has urged the Electoral Commission to start the voters registration exercise in places outside the partial lockdown. The Electoral Commission suspended its planned compilation of a new voters register over the ban on public gatherings imposed on Ghanaians as part of efforts to curb the spread of the coronavirus. Now, the exercise was initially scheduled for April 18, 2020. Samo Kujeto, who is also a member of the Council of State, in an interview on Eyewitness News said the EC can compile the voters register in batches. And according to him, our cases of the coronavirus is not as dramatic as it is in many countries. I'm quoting him, which means that we only have few pockets in the two big municipalities and few of the smaller ones.
Since the lockdown
is not the whole of Ghana, the EC should start the registration in areas where there is
Forgotten what the president directed last week about the extension of the ban in public gatherings. This is not just a lockdown issue.
Mm.
Now, how do you construe a registration not to be a public gathering? When we ask the NIA forcefully to stop their registration, how is EC going to open the register and register people in an era of ban of public gatherings? Maybe he didn't avert his mind to that fact. Now, the best article on this I've seen is written by CDD's Kojo Asante. He's given three options. He's basically saying, if by June we are not able to register people, they should drop the idea of a new register, use the old register, negotiate with STL, and have the election on the basis of the old register. Because if we force ourselves after June to start the registration process, mm-hmm. the timelines will be too short and we're going to run into a lot of problems.
Okay, let me tell you about defiant citizens who have been arrested by the police. Then we can go international. A lot of stories internationally as well.
Yes.
So Timothy Nyengwe writes on page 20 of the Daily Graphic that the police have arrested 406 people for flouting the movement on restrictions order imposed by the president. Now, the head of the legal and prosecutions at the Accra Regional Police Command, ACP Lydia Donko, made this known at the press briefing held by the Minister of Information. She said the suspects were arrested for offences such as holding weddings, going to beaches and holding parties in gross violation of the Imposition of Restrictions Act 2020. Mm-hmm. Providing further information on the status of the suspects, she said 103 of them were in police custody, while 248 had been granted bail. The remaining 41, she said, were being processed for court. I can take you international.
I had wanted to do another local one, but I think we've done enough. Finally, government gives MTN and Vodafone free spectrum for 3 months. This is citybusinessnews.com. And the government of Ghana has provided extra spectrum to Vodafone and MTN Ghana amid the increased pressure on bandwidth following the spike in data usage in recent times. There's been an upsurge in data usage due to coronavirus-induced lockdown of parts of the country, which has compelled a lot of people to stay at home. In a bit to reduce boredom, most of these people at home spend their time getting in touch with friends and loved ones online. According to the Ministry of Communication, the extra spectrum is being given to the two companies at no cost and will last them for 3 months. Mm. The president has directed that the NCA should give more bandwidth to telcos during this period for free, and that has been done. Minister for Communication Esla Usuekufu said at a press briefing yesterday.
Bernard, I know we want to go international, but final local story. Mm-hmm. The Ghanaian Times: calls besiege Kwame Nkrumah Circle for food.
Charlie.
And the story says, scores of desperately looking young men and women yesterday gathered under the Kwame Nkrumah Circle overpass near the new plant station in Accra, frantically begging for food and money as the region entered its third week of the partial lockdown. The lockdown is an emergency protocol to control the spread of the coronavirus pandemic. And they write that about 150 people gathered under the overpass begging for food and money.
Some were demanding. It's pretty scary if you see what's going on there. Right. Let's go international.
Yes, Bernard, I have a story that I know you want to do the Trump World Health Organization story.
Oh, I wanted to do the AC one.
Okay, yes. I'll give you the AC in a bit, but
yeah.
The World Health Organization has issued criteria for relaxing lockdowns.
Okay, what are they?
Yes, that's on page 9 of the Daily Graphic. So they are basically saying that lessons learned from China and South Korea on how to best emerge from lockdown restrictions and on what needs to be in place to avoid a second wave of infection. So the criteria includes, now if you're a government who wants to lift lockdowns,
mm-hmm.
transmission is controlled, health systems have the ability to quickly detect, test, isolate and treat new cases, mm-hmm. as well as to trace close contacts. Outbreaks are minimized in some settings, such as health facilities and retirement villages.
Mm-hmm.
Preventative measures are put into place in workplaces, schools and shops. Importation risks are managed and communities are educated, engaged and empowered to adjust to a new norm.
Mm.
So these are the criteria that the World Health Organization is putting down if you want to lift.
Okay, now there's a very worrying one. U.S. may have to endure social distancing until 2022 if no vaccine is found.
Search on CNN.
According to scientists, the headline explains itself. So.
Yes, and then let me tell you about the AC one now.
Mm-hmm.
If you go to go to the South China Morning Post, you will find that story by Wendy Wu.
Mm.
She has also become a favorite of Bernard's in the past month or so. A study of 10 coronavirus cases from 3 families who dined at the same restaurant in southern China suggested that air conditioning aided droplet transmission between them.
Mm.
Strong airflow from the air conditioner could have propagated droplets between 3 tables, according to the report of the research based on the infections in the city of Guangzhou in late January. Droplet transmission alone could not explain the infections, it concluded. Restaurants should increase the space between tables and improve ventilation to reduce the risk of infection, according to the report of the research led by Jianyun Lu of the Guangzhou Center for Disease Control and Prevention.
Now, still globally, U.S. President Donald Trump, this is the BBC, says he has instructed his administration to stop funding to the World Health Organization. He said the WHO had failed in its basic duty in its response to the coronavirus outbreak. He accused the UN body of mismanaging and covering up the spread of the virus after it emerged in China and said it must be held accountable. Mr. Trump has previously accused the WHO of being biased towards China. The U.S. president has himself come under criticism at home over his handling of the outbreak. Then here's the quote: "I am directing my administration to halt funding while a review is conducted to assess the WHO's role in severely mismanaging and covering up the spread of the coronavirus, Mr. Trump told a news conference in the White House.
There's been a response to that from Bill Gates, also on CNN, he has denounced U.S. President Donald Trump's decision to halt funding of the World Health Organization. According to him, halting funding for the World Health Organization during a world health crisis is as dangerous as it sounds.
So is he going to make up the difference?
Yes, he says their work is slowing the spread of COVID-19, and if that work is stopped, no other organization can replace them.
What I want to hear is, so because of that, I, Bill Gates, I'm donating $1 billion what America will be giving until he comes back.
But knowing Bill, it's something that will come up.
We need to hear that because it's challenging.
But that's also,
to be fair, the U.S. supports a lot of these agencies, a lot of money. Yes. So if the U.S.
15%
money is not coming, if the U.S. money is not coming,
I will see people like Bill and Bloomberg just saying
Amazon
Trump
and things.
Koda,
it's very important too. Otherwise, the WHO will be hot. The WHO will be hot. So I think we need to end it here, gentlemen. Yes. There's a lot more coming up on the show today. Thank you very much. Coming up next is the City Business News. Stay with us.
Sometimes musical perfection comes from collaboration. A collection of talented individuals can create something beautiful. And this is also true in life. Because when we work together, the result can be exceptional. That's why Fidelity Bank will always be by your side to help you achieve your goals. You and Fidelity, because together we are so much more.
Fidelity Bank. Believe with us.
What does extra mean to you?
Extra means child data.
More minutes to talk to my loved ones.
Data that doesn't expire.
More talk.